بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Brothers in Islam, welcome to lesson 102 of العربية بين يديك, book 1 part 1 of the new version. وقفنا عند الصفحة 225. We stopped at page 225 and we were talking about the hand and the arm. Like I've mentioned, the word hand can be called yadun. Likewise, the word arm can also be called yadun. So it really depends on the context. Okay. So yadun can be arm or hand. But the Arabs, they have also some names for particular places of the hand. For particular places of the arm. So for example, the word adudun. Adudun is the upper hand. Adudun is this part of the hand between the shoulder and the elbow. So adudun bidadi, with the tongue inside, because it's not a dha with a stick. يَجُوزُ تَذْكِيرُهُ وَتَأْنِيثُهُ. It's allowed to make it masculine and feminine. So you can say هَذَا عَضُدٌ وَهَذِهِ عَضُدٌ وَالْجَمْعُ أَعْضَادٌ. What is the upper arm? I'm not sure if I said upper hand. I mean upper arm. Okay? The upper arm between the shoulder and the elbow. This is called عَضُدٌ. And I also want to share with you the word mirfaqun. And you can say it in two ways. This is elbow. You can say marfiqun and mirfaqun. This is actually the word that I personally use. أنا شخصياً أستخدم هذه الكلمة. أنا شخصياً, I personally أستخدم, I use هذه الكلمة, this word مرفقون, but who am I? I mean, you can say both مرفقون and مرفقون. Somebody might use مرفقون more and somebody might use مرفقون more. I think it's just the way that I have learned it as مرفقون. وهي كلمة مذكرة. It's a masculine word. Although there are two of in the body. للإنسان مرفقان. The human being has two elbows. والجمع مرافقون. This is a very important word because this comes in the Ayat al-Wudu in Surah al-Ma'idah. وأيديكم إلى المرافق. So you have to wash up to the مرافق, including the elbow. والله أعلم. So مرافق is ممنوع من الصرف. You can see مرافق has one dhamma. And this is similar to those words that I've told you, masajidu and mafatihu, masks and keys. So this is also an important word because it is linked to the topic of الوضوء. مرفقون والجمعو مرافقو. أيضا هناك جزء آخر من اليد. هناك أيضا, there is also جزء آخر, it's another part, من اليد, of the arm, وهو الذراع. And that is this word, ذراعٌ. ذراعٌ is the forearm, okay? Between the elbow and the wrist. This is called ذراعٌ, okay? And a Muslim should not put his ذراع on the ground while doing sujood. This is a mistake. It's a bad, nasty mistake. Bad and nasty mistake. Because this is done by some animals, as mentioned in the hadith, that you should not do it like, I forgot which animals mentioned in the hadith, I think it's Sahih Muslim, but you should raise your forearm while doing sujood, okay? You should raise your forearm and not put your forearms on the ground like some of the animals do. Thank you. صحيح مسلم حديث نمبر 498 حديث نمبر 498 نعم وينهى أن يفترش الرجل and it's and he forbids that أن يفترش الرجل ذراعيه افتراش السبع to put lie down your forearms like the praying animal does the hunting animal the praying animal like a lion like a like a tiger etc wallahu a'lam anyway you can go back to the translation of the hadith 498 sahih muslim this is one of the mistakes that many people make subhanallah A beast of prey, a predatory animal. So we should not resemble him and do like him in prayer. بعد ذلك أيها الإخوة, after that, my brothers in Islam. So, ذراعٌ is the forearm. Okay, ذراعٌ is what the forearm. Is this an important word? Definitely, it's a very important word. Not just because of the hadith. And ذِرَاعٌ, by the way, يَجُوزُ تَذْكِيرُهُ وَتَأْنِيثُهُ It's allowed to make it masculine and feminine. وَالْجَمْعُ أَذْرُعٌ و... نعم, وَالْجَمْعُ أَذْرُعٌ The plural is أَذْرُعٌ وَذِرَاعُ الْإِنسَانِ مِنَ الْمِرْفَقِ إِلَى الرُّسْغِ This is the definition of what? Of a ذِرَاعُ وَذِرَاعُ الْإِنسَانِ And the forearm of the human being مِنَ الْمِرْفَقِ It's from the elbow إلى to is حرف جر so the next words اسم مجرور gets a كسرة إلى الرسغ so it's shed on the and a ضم on the ra it's from the elbow to the ما معنى الرسغ رسغ is a wrist we will get that inshallah why is this so important this word ذراع and why is the Islam so much there is so much connection between the word ذراع and the Islam. Why is there so much connection between the Ahadith and the word Dira'un? I will tell you why. Dira'un, my brothers in Islam, Dira'un, before that, Afwan. Dira'un muradifun li sa'idun. So we have another word for forearm, that is sa'idun. Okay? Wal jam'u sawa'idu. Forearms. Sa'idani is two forearms. Sa'idun is famous, but Dira'un is very famous. Both mean forearm. And now it will come. Now I will mention why the word Dira'un is so important. الدِّرَاعُ أيها الإخوة مِقْيَاسٌ It's a measurement. الدِّرَاعُ or without L. دِرَاعٌ مِقْيَاسٌ It's a measurement. Okay. وَأَشْهَرُهُ الْمِقْيَاسُ الْهَاشِمِيُّ And the most famous dira', the measurement dira' is the Hashimi one. وهو 64 centimeters. So, you know, the scholars they differed about the dira' because there are multiple types of dira'. Okay. So the most famous one is the Hashimi dira', and you know that the dira', if you look to the ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ, you will find many ahadiths where the Prophet ﷺ mentioned the word dira', dira'un. So the scholars, when you know they tried to ease for the people the understanding of this measurement, so they tried to figure out how many centimeters or how many centimeters the dira' is. So they found out that the most important and the most famous dira' is the Hashimi dira'. And you know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the word Hashimi, it's not you're not unfamiliar with. The word Al Hashimi comes from the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he's Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ibn Abdullah, the son of Abdullah, ibn Abd Al Muttalib, the son of Abd Al Muttalib, who was his grandfather, ibn Hashim. So the father of his grandfather was Hashim. So the Hashimi dira is the most famous one. So what is the measurement of the dira? It's 64 centimeters, my brothers in Islam. 64 centimeters. I give you a hadith. And you can see the hadith, subhanAllah, because the writing style, this hadith that I have added here, it's written with another writing style, so you can see it's not very clear. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه and the authority of أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said خلق الله آدم Allah created آدم وطوله 60 ذراعا and his height, his tallness was 60 ذراع. It's one of the ahadiths. And let me double check. I just between the brackets I quickly tried to calculate 60 multiplied by 0.64. Yes, it's 38 meters, 0.4. 60 dira, if we take this measurement, Allah created Adam and his tallness was 60 dira. And when multiplied by 64 centimeters, we get 38 meters, 0.4. Then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَكُلُّ مَنْ يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ So everyone that enters the paradise على صورة آدم will have the same shape as Adam عليه السلام. فلم يزل الخلق ينقص حتى الآن. So the creation is continuing decreasing in tallness until now. And the hadith is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari in his Sahih. رقم الحديث 3000 3326 3326. You can go back to this beautiful hadith and it should encourage us to work for the paradise. بعد ذلك أيها الإخوة عندنا رسغن. أنتم تعرفون معنى الرسخ لأن الكلمة قد مرت بنا قبل قليل because the word we have just gone through. You should know the word رسغن. I just mentioned it maybe a few minutes ago. رسغن is the wrist. والجمع أرساغن وأرسغن. أرساغن وأرسغن. بعد ذلك going back to the word yadun, my brothers in Islam, we have the word kaffun, shadda and to dhamma on the fa. Kaffun, kalimatun mu'annathatun. What is the word kaffun? Kaffun, al-jam'u, akuffun, is the palm of the hand palm. Kaffun, kaffun, is the palm of the hand. Wa al-jam'u, أكفن is feminine word. فائدة we have done elbow. It's mentioned here again. I've mentioned it twice now. مرفقون just as a reminder, it's elbow. It's a masculine word. وهو اسم مذكر. It's a masculine noun. الجمع مرافق ممنوع من الصرف. بعد ذلك أيها الإخوة after that نذهب إلى كلمة we go to the word أصبعون. أصبعون كلمة مؤنثة is a feminine word. نعم، كلمة مؤنثة أصبع، والجمع أصابع، ممنوع من الصرف. وكلمة أصبع، the word أصبع، تشتمل أو تشمل it contains أصابع اليد وأصابع القدم. This is very important. The word أصبع. Okay. I know in English you have fingers, you have toes. In the Arabic language, the word أصبع and its plural أصابع, it contains the fingers of the hand and the toes of the foot. So the toes of the foot, they are also أصابع. Okay. How do we distinguish? We say أصابع اليد, the fingers of the hand, وأصابع القدم, the fingers of the foot, literally the fingers of the foot. I know that in English you don't say fingers of the foot, but this is the linguistically translation, the fingers of the foot. So what is a finger? أصبعون. What are fingers? أصابعوا. What is one toe? أصبعون والجمع أصابع والله أعلم. طيب، there is a beautiful benefit of الشيخ ابن عثيمين رحمه الله, and this is inshallah something I will start with in the next class inshallah. Until then inshallah, سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.